It's a great privilege for me and Mark to perform here, and I'm thankful to Indira ji and Dr. Meenakshi Gopinath, a very, very old friend, and the Sarvodaya International Trust for inviting us to perform for an occasion which, as Ritu said a while ago, has become a very, very important occasion, particularly in the kind of context that the country is going through today. For me, it's a great honor to be here, and I'm not sure whether I deserve this honor. I hope I'll be able to do justice to the occasion. We are going to be singing Resistance. We are going to be singing some, performing some songs which come from India's history of the anti-colonial struggle, and also after India gained independence. We'll start with a song that was written after the Jallianwala Bagh massacre. We don't know exactly when it was written. It was written by an anonymous poet, but it was first publicly sung by a singer of the Indian People's Theatre Association, Preeti Sarkar. She was a singer in the central squad of the IPTA, which was located in Bombay, and which had a whole range of eminent artists, musicians, dancers, photographers, painters, who came together in the year 1943 to form this organization called the Indian People's Theatre Association, which was to use culture as a mode of articulating resistance. The song was composed by an anonymous poet, as I said, and used to be sung by Preeti Sarkar, who at the time was considered one of India's best singers. And this was something that was said by none other than Pandit Ravi Shankar, who was a member of the IPTA Central Squad at that time.
Goal.
This is another song from the early 1940s. It's a Heer, which was written by Sheila Bhatia about the Bengal famine. When the famine was ravaging many parts of eastern and some parts of northern India as well, there was a big rally that was held, a peasants' rally that was held in Lahore to not only raise awareness about what was happening to people in Bengal, but also to generate solidarity among the peasants of Punjab towards their brothers and sisters in Bengal. It was also a period when the British were cleverly playing politics between the governments of Punjab and the governments of Bengal, in a way in which it became impossible for grain to move from Punjab to Bengal. So while we would still know that there were several songs that were written in Bangla at the time of the Bengal famine, which came often from the poets who were witnessing the famine firsthand, this is a song that was written far away in Lahore. It was sung at this big gathering, which reportedly had about 80,000 people attending it, and was sung at the time by a young artist, singer, Swatantrata, who taught me this song a few years ago before she passed away. This is a Heer about the Bengal famine.
दसा दुख दर्द सहियों किनु फूल दसा दुख दर्द सहियों mera rog tala ilaaj dise kar kaat sai kanu chuthe सवाल है बिना जवाब दिसे सितका में मन दी पड़ास दिसे किनु फूल दसा दुख दर्द सहियों मेरा रो ताला इलाज दिसे कर काट साई कनु छुटे मैं थो क्यों सवाल है बिना जवाब दिसे
The next song was written by Makhdoom Mohiuddin at the time of the Second World War. It was called Jaane Wale Sipahi Se Poochho Wo Kahan Ja Raha Hai. And this song was written by Makhdoom as he was traveling back home in a rickshaw from the railway station in Hyderabad where he lived after attending a conference elsewhere in the country. And as he passed in the rickshaw, he saw a whole procession of emaciated, extremely impoverished people who had been conscripted for the army and who were being taken to fight someone else's war. This was written and composed by Makhdoom. It used to be performed in the 40s and in the 50s as well, when Makhdoom himself would sing it. And it was also used in a film in a slightly modified form called Usne Kaha Tha. It was set to music by Salil Chaudhary. But then it went out of public memory. I happen to have had the good fortune of being one of the people who revived the song in 1984. And this is soon after Mrs. Gandhi's assassination, when a carnage broke out in many parts of India against the Sikh community. And this song was revived in Khalsa College. This is when I was an undergraduate student in Delhi University. And there was a big peace march which was organized by a citizens collective. There would be many people here who might remember. And this march went through different colleges of Delhi University, collecting relief for people who were in the camps, but also appealing for peace and calm. And it ended in Khalsa College, where a large number of people from the Sikh community had gathered, because that was one of the few places which was safe, particularly for the men who were being particularly targeted. And the atmosphere was extremely tense, and there were a large number of young Sikh men who actually also in desperation wanted revenge. And we had just learnt this song, and it was taught to me and the group that I used to perform with by Safdar Hashmi, who himself became a target of horrible violence a few years later. And at that point, when the atmosphere was extremely tense in Khalsa College, Safdar whispered in my ear and said, "Sing that song." And I was a young, obstinate student, and I turned around and I said, "But this is a song about the Second World War. What relevance does it have here?" He said, "Sing, I'll explain to you later." And so this song, we sang the song, and it was magical. It was magical because it actually completely changed the atmosphere. It was cathartic. There were the people who were in a rage, whose faces were contorted with anger, actually went down on their knees and cried. For me, this was a very, very important moment in my life, and also told me what singing resistance can be. So we'll sing Jaane Wale Sipahi Se Poochho.
जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है, जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है, जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है, कैसे सहमे हुए हैं नजारे, कैसे डर डर के जल से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है, गिर रहा है सिर वतन छोड़ कर जाने वाले खुल गया इनकलाबी भरेरा सिपाही से पूछो वो कहाँ जा रहा है जाने वाले सिपाही से पूछो
The next song is a more upbeat one. This was written. Okay. Right. Yeah, we're going to end with this song. It's called Dola. This is a song that was written by Bhupen Hazarika, and he was talking about the condition of the palanquin bearers. The Dola bearers and what happens to them and how they talk about their lives as they carry people on their shoulders in palanquins.
He dola, he dola, he dola, he dola, he dola, he dola, he unchi nichi teri meri sadko pe liye daude jaate hain raja ka dola, he dola, he dola, he dola, he apne jism ke khoon pasine ke bal pe chalte hi dola, he dola, he dola, he dola, he unchi hi nichi sadko pe liye hum जाते हैं राजा का डोला ई डोला अपने जिस्म के खून पसीने के बल पे चलत ई डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे ऊंची नीची टेढ़ी मेढ़ी सड़कों पे लिए दौड़े जाते हैं राजा का डोला हे डोला हे अपने जिस्म के खून पसीने के बल पे चलत ई डोला हे डोला हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला सज के ओ बैठे हैं डोले के भीतर आज और जगमग जगमग करते हैं सर पे सोने चांदी का ताज ए रेशमी लिबासों में सज के ओ बैठे हैं डोले के भीतर आज को ढकने को नहीं एक चोला हाय मोर बिटुआ के नंगे बदन को ढकने को नहीं एक चोला आँखियों में पानी आए फिर भी चलत जाए मनवा को बांधी डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे ऊंची नीची टेढ़ी मेढ़ी सड़कों पे लिए दौड़े जाते हैं राजा का डोला हे डोला हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला जुग जुग से डोला कांधे पे चलत है कमर टूट टूट जाए हो जाए हे जुग जुग से डोला कांधे पे चलत है कमर टूट टूट जाए हो जाए हे राजा बाबू सोवत है निंदिया के गोद में अपना पसीना बहा जाए हो जाए हे ऊंचे ऊंचे पहाड़ों पे चलत जात है कदम से कदम मिला पहाड़ों पे चलत जात है कदम से कदम मिलाए अगर फिसल के गिरी है ये जानू तो फिर ना उठिए डोला राजा महाराजा का डोला बड़े बड़े लोगन का डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे डोला हे ऊंची नीची टेढ़ी मेढ़ी सड़कों पे लिए दौड़े जाते हैं डोला हे अपने जिस्म के खून पसीने के बल पे चलत ही डोला हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे हैया ना हैया ना हैया ना हैया हे डोला 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 हे डोला
Although we said this is our last song, I'd actually like to end with something slightly different. And we'll just take a few minutes. I want to sing a few lines from a song, the poem for which has been written by a dear friend, Ari Sitas, who's a South African poet, sociologist, dramatist, and civic activist. And the reason why I want to read this poem and also sing a little bit of its translation into Urdu, which was done by a young teacher in an Adivasi school in Madhya Pradesh, is because the poet himself has been involved in the anti-apartheid movement and has also worked on the idea of the ethic of reconciliation. He's written a book called The Ethic of Reconciliation and looked quite extensively at Gandhiji's ideas on nonviolence as a philosophy of praxis. And also in the context of the process of reconciliation that was initiated in South Africa after the transition, where those who had been oppressed had the generosity to let the oppressor into their hearts. And in tribute to that idea, and in tribute to the internationalism of Gandhiji's philosophy of non-violence, I'd like to sing a small part of this song. It started from a butterfly spinning. Once, twice. The poem is called The Insurrection of the Flowers. It started from a butterfly spinning, once, twice, dropping dead. I cannot remember lightning or thunder. All I remember is the lull. Water stood still. The drop from the leaky tap stood still. The tears from my eyes stood still. Before the flowers burst the ramparts in what they called the insurgency of the flowers. They were everywhere, leaping from vases, snapping free from bunches. And there, flocks of jasmine, murders of hyacinth, parading up and down the emptying streets. The rumor spread to the trees and they bloomed. Roses conspired with almond blossoms. The Dangabane flower resurrected. The Kurinji blues intoned.
शहादत यूं भी होती है ना कोई अब्र गरजा था ना कोई बर्क चमकी थी मुझे बस याद है खामोशियों के बाद खामोशी कहीं नरगिस कहीं मरियम कहीं सुंबुल कहीं सूसन बगावत यूं भी होती है
थैंक यू वेरी मच